Okay, I was gonna say, there's clearly something I did not pick up there. I mean, there is a boat out there that I guess you can use, like, jump to it, replenish your stamina, and then swim, but it seems like you're just kind of hoping. I don't like that guy. So he had to die. Okay, you guys have not scared me today. The islands out there. I can see a ship out there, way in the, like, in the background. Just jump up. Don't jump forward. Up. Hill of trail here. This is going to bring us to our moment of truth here. Is there any way to get out there? That island doesn't seem too far. All things considered. I don't care about you right now. There's a lot of violet grass around here on the edges of everything. Okay, I think we can make that. Wait, what is this? Someone's bags and books. Some slime is down there. I think we can make that. But we'll have to be very careful. We can make that. But the problem is we have to work our way around, because the hunt is over there on the right, and we'll be starting over here on the left. But I don't think that's too problematic. And if we can find there's a fast travel point on the second island. I can mark that so that we can get out here easier next time. I'm not going to explore these islands. We're just going for the treasure hunt, so I know there's a chest there, but unless I see like an item here that is telling me to pick up, like maybe this conch. These items are specialties, I think. can fuck off.
Yeah.
Sealy thing here. Okay, where is it? Oh, there it is. Oh, we made it! We have to get over there. I don't think I can swim that distance. That is where we need to be going, right? Yeah, it's down in that area. Specifically, the whole fucking bottom bit. So we have to do two more island hops to get there. How did the fuck did these Hillichurls just get their own little island? We've got all three different types of crossbow, guys. This place will be really fun to explore. It's very beautiful. She's out here?
She's everywhere. She's in my dreams.
Oh, we've made it. Look at the size of the... Look at the map. Look at how big the area is. Yeah. I know that most of it's water, but holy tits, bank. Better make sure I grab as much as I freaking can here. Oh, there's some fruit just in the sand. What is that thing there? What is the tornado thing? I'm not gonna touch it right now. It looks like a blowhole. Let's touch it. Ruins treasure. My fellow disciple and I trained in the martial arts from childhood. Our quest was to fight forces of evil and protect the sacred world. Or what it, all that is sacred in this world. It's no easy task. Lot of crystal out here. There's more on that island over there. Look, there's a little island for just a treasure thing. Oh, shit. Where is it? I don't want to piss that guy off right now. Ah, hello, my friends. Oh, okay. Meanwhile, the freaking flower has taken the least amount of damage. I know he's the higher level item? He's the higher level thing here, but... There's two of them out here. More! Two times in a row, man. Wow, you're an asshole. Oh, there's another ruins treasure thing here. There's another one there. There's no treasure nearby thus far. Don't tell me it's right in the middle of where those ruin guards guys are. I mean, I know I don't need the Sealy in order to see the treasure. He just helps me get closer to it. I'm having trouble pinpointing. Oh my god, we got it. Okay. Lost treasures. Where is that? It must be off to the west. That looks like the edge of the map there. Is this the last place as well? Yeah, this is the last treasure area, guys. Yeah, it's up here. The closest area I have is this. Well, I was gonna just go to that island, but it looks kind of far away. Because the next closest place I have is here. Yeah, let's follow the path. Let's ignore everything, follow the path. And we'll see if I can glide across the water. We can make that. Look at that over there. That looks pretty cool. Can't go over there, though. I'm gonna need to get something to eat today as well, at some point. I don't really have anything, you know, nifty, like anything particular. I'm craving homemade stroganoff again. Had that like 3 times in the past 2 months. Because it's good. You can fuck off, you know? Ooh, what are these red things? Oh, they're just back ends of snapdragons. Hey guys, how's it going? Hey, how's it going? Okay, we have entered the region. The last one we gotta do. Well, except that challenge that I'm gonna go check out too. Where is it? It's okay, this way.
Well,
that's going away. Hello. Oh, you want to do this to us now. Well, that was easy. Excuse me. A boiled egg. Treasure seeking Seely has not detected any shit nearby. Please look elsewhere in the area. Okay. Well, we didn't go over here. No, no, no. Why? Yes! We finished that battle pass thing as well now. This BP period, that's 12,000 points, or not 12,000, 1,200 points it's worth. So that just boosted us up two levels. Which is worth some adventurer's experience, some mystic enhancement ore. So we still have to do that for our daily mission. That shouldn't be too hard. Okay, we're getting halfway to that task for the weekly thing. I think the boss enemies are include those cubes, because it says 2 out of 10 and we fought 2 of those cubes. I'll see if I can fight those cubes again, maybe. I don't know what these challenges are here. The 1200 resin. I don't know. Maybe? No, not for the weekly challenge. We won't reach. Spend a total of 500,000 mora. That's possible. Cook 20 dishes. We can do that. Forge 20 items. We can do that. We could probably grind out 15 domain challenges. Complete 3 quests. Requests. I don't know what a request or a bounty is. We don't have that. I don't know what a crimson wish is. You get that from that crimson tree. And complete 1 golden house challenge. I don't know what that is either, so fuck it. Original resin. Yeah, 5,500 original resin. I'm sure we could probably yoink that out in 15 days. I don't know what 12 stars and spiral abyss is. Oh, there's not many of them here. Raise Frostbearing Tree to level 8? We could probably manage that. Okay, so Lost Riches is done. Exchange shop. So here's what you can buy. So for we have 840. And we can buy up to 300 Prima Gems. We can buy one of the mini Seelies as well. And then there's a whole bunch of other stuff you can buy. Well, I say a whole bunch, but you know what I mean. Okay, but before we do that, before we go and purchase anything, we need to go back down here so that I can try that co-op challenge and see if I can get that done. Then I will claim my rewards, and we have completed this thing. have to kind of try to find it again. There it is. Now, if other guys spawn around that chest, though, that could cause issues. Well, let me see. Well, first thing we'll do is we'll look to see what the challenge actually is. Blow up 6 exploding barrels within 15 seconds. Okay, I'm just trying to see where they are. And I can do this, right? Okay, that shouldn't be too bad, maybe. We did it, right? Yes. That was 50,000 more. Okay. Okay, that wasn't too bad at all. All right. Now, let me go. Let me go back to What? My brain died. Yeah, let's go back to Mondstadt for a second. And then, let me go to our lost riches, and let's go to the exchange shop. So let's buy ourselves a mini Sealy. So there's the Dayflower one, which is blue. So let's see. So the blue one, unlike other Sealy, it does not serve to guide others, but to follow them to see the world. So that's the blue one. But like the blue ones in the world that I guess take you to chest. The rosé one is a miniature pink or powder pink Sealy. Though it cannot say a word, it will silently follow the traveler and strike its fancy around the world. And then the golden one gives off a feeling very similar to that of Mora. They say it represents good fortune. So really, I like the pink one, right? My least favorite is the golden one, but I like the pink one. But blue is my favorite color, so I think it would just make most sense for me to go for the blue one. So, yes, exchange. Yeah, now I can't do the other ones. That's sad that you can't get all three, but whatever. Okay, now I'm of course going to go for the primogems. All three. So that's 300 primogems there. That's awesome. And then I don't know what I should use the rest of it on. The enhancement, or how much would that cost? Like, that's 80 to do it. Yeah, let's do the enhancement ore. And then the hero's wit is probably what people would tell me to use the rest of it on. Well, that's only 80. So you can afford everything then. Oh, look at that. If you do all of it, they actually give you just enough iron coins to buy everything in the shop, with the exception of the 3 Sealies, since they only allow you to get one. Okay. Well, that's awesome. There we go. I bought everything from their shop then. Now, how does this little Sealy work? Look, guys, we have a little pet. I hope they expand the pet feature, unless there already is more companions in the game, because that would be so freaking awesome. Oh, that's really cool. Nice. I know it's really simple and stuff, but I think I tried explaining this earlier, that I really like having companions in these types of games. The only scary part is that if they start implementing a real companion feature, they'll have a special gacha banner just for getting companions. And I would spend every penny I have. What's it doing? It's doing cute things. And he has ears. Okay, good. So we've accomplished one of the tasks. Now let me go back through the event and make sure. So that's lost riches done. And fate foretold is... is stuff that we've already done. All right. Oh, I guess the reason it's still on here is because I don't think we have this Favonous Warbow. Okay, and then we've got... That's the chat. That's the limited time event for that character. That we'll have to see if we can do at some point. I don't know. I don't know what the three purple things are. That's easy enough to do. We can do that just by logging in. We'll come to that. And then there's the test run with the two different characters from the current banner. Get some primogems and some other shit. Should we do those now? Before I go to get something to eat? Just because they're here? And we get an extra 20 gems. Fuck it. Let's go. Let's try Ganyu. Let's see. She's the level star, head honcho of the current banner. Let's see if she's fun. She's cute. Character description. Ganyu's aimed shots... Whoa, aimed? Does she have a bow? Can be charged twice. And when such an arrow hits, it will cause a frost flake to burst and deal AoE cryo damage. Okay, her elemental skill allows her to swiftly retreat and deploy an ice lotus that attracts enemy attacks. When this ice lotus blooms or wilts, it will deal AoE cryo damage. Ganyu's elemental burst summons a sacred cryo pearl that will continuously attack opponents in a large AoE with a rain of ice shards for a certain duration. Okay. So, that's the double charge there, I guess. Oh, did you see that? That's pretty cool. Okay. And then here's the Ice Lotus thing. Right, so it's an, oh shit, get the fuck out thing. Enemies will attack it and then it'll burst. And give off a whole bunch of shit. And then we've got Barbara over here, who's another character I don't have yet. You think she likes music? Okay, and then they give me Kea. Okay. Alright, I think she could be fun. I didn't exactly see what her burst was. Celestial Shower. Sacred Cryo Pearl that exercises evil. During its ability duration, its Sacred Cryo Pearl will continuously rain down shards. Right, okay. So it's just an AoE of fuck you with ice. Hello! I want to see this work here. I love that attack where it does like a burst of little shards down like that. That's really freaking awesome. Look at that. That is so cool. That's like, even though Fischl's extremely awesome because of her electro abilities, she doesn't have that because that's kind of the problem with using her against multiple enemies. She can't do this. I like that. Okay, let's try this again. Hello. Current challenge complete. You may leave the stage. I think she could be really fun, especially since she's a bow user that can attack multiple enemies with a single shot. How about this character then? Looks like a dude, and he's water. So I don't know how to pronounce his name. Ching Chu, maybe? Elemental skill hits opponents. They will form rain swords that protect him and his allies. His elemental burst activates rainbow blade work, which will immediately summon the largest possible number of rain swords and launch consecutive attacks. Whoosh! Look at that, I got rain swords. I could use him as well, because we need a water dude. Alright, let me wait for that thing to replenish. Okay. Let's try this here. Okay, he's a little weak, but maybe that's why they give us Kea here to like freeze. It looks like he's best when they get all circled up around me, because then I can do that. I see you. So when I'm attacking stuff, and that's shooting the little sword things down. That's his burst. Oh, hello, sir. So I can probably freeze these guys with Kea, and that's why it's having me do that. Like so. Yeah. So we're basically just continuously freezing him when I combine Kea's abilities. Okay, I guess, I don't know. I definitely preferred playing as Ganyu out of the two characters, but I do desperately need a Hydro character. But we've gotten the test runs out of the way, so this time I won't leave it until like the last minute to do them. If we keep that stuff going, I want to definitely grind more of these gems. I want more of those fates, damn it. Because I definitely want to try to get Ganyu now. That would be really, really nice. Okay, so what are we... I think this is where I'm going to call it for right now, and then I can come back later. Plus, my hard drive's getting a little low, so I could do with uploading for a couple hours. I'm just trying to figure out what we want to do next. I think next time, what we're going to do, since I've caught up on some of the limited time stuff, is I'm going to look at some of the... Oh, that's what I was going to the Battle Pass. I want to look to see if there's any of the weekly things that we can maybe grind out quick. Like these specialty things, and maybe spending Mora, we can find stuff to upgrade. And the cooking dishes, stuff like that. Get as many of these as done as we can. And then I think I want to go back and continue that main story quest we were on just to finish off that area. I want to get those two waypoints so I can get more primogems, because now I really want to grind primogems, because I want to try to get as many of those fates as I can. We have plenty of time. Well, how long does her banner last? Let me see. It lasts until the end of time. 17 days. So basically until the end of the month. Okay, so that's... Wait, what is 17 days from now? It's the 16th. Yeah, basically until the end of the month. We have zero of these fates. Should we use these right now? I'm thinking like maybe we should use... Well, maybe not. Every 10 wishes is a guaranteed 4-star or higher. And we've got 10 to use. And there's a lot of characters, and that's me trying to drag the screen. There's a lot of characters in here. I mean, for 5 stars, you've got a whole bunch of people I don't know about. And then you've got, I mean, look at how many 4-star characters there are in this. You could literally get anybody. There's quite a few that people have been telling me about that I wouldn't mind trying to see what they're all about. Like, people have been telling me about Diona, whatever. They want me to get her or him. I'm assuming it's a her. Because who the fuck likes the dudes? I've seen Razor because a friend of mine got him. He doesn't look too bad. He looks pretty fun. I would like to get some of Xiangling's duplicates so that I can unlock some of her other abilities. But I'll do that. You know what? We'll do that next time. We'll roll the fiver or tenner next time.